Hello, I'm M. Shivakumar, Assistant Professor, ECE Department, Anurag University, Hyderabad, Telangana. I'm making these videos in a playlist called as Google Basics of Google Classroom. As part of it, in the last video, second video, we have seen what is Stream Tab and how Stream Tab is used in Google Classroom. In this video, we'll see Tab classwork and how Tab classwork is used in Google Classroom. Now in Classwork tab, we have many options. This is the tab which is mainly used to communicate with students, interact with students. Now in this tab, we have a button called as Create. Under Create, we have an Assignment tab to create assignment, Quiz tab to create quiz, Question tab to create question, Material tab to create material, Reuse Post tab to repost already what we have posted, and Topic tab to organize the classwork we have created. In the same tab, we have Google Meet to interact with the students using Google Meet app or Google Meet web. Then to schedule a class, we use Google Calendar. Then whatever the material we post in classwork, all that material will be saved in class drive folder in our drive, Google Drive. So whenever a teacher posts a certain material, it is saved in class teacher's drive, and whenever student answers any one of assignments, questions, or if they submit anything, that is saved in student's class drive. Now these are the tabs which are available in under classwork type of Google Classroom. Alright, under the Create tab, first we'll create a topic. The first topic I'll put it as Course Information or Course Information, and I'll click on Add. Now when it is added, right, under Course, right. Now what I'll do, to add the material or to make a course information, what I'll do, I'll add a material, then as a title I'll give as course syllabus copy. BTEC SEM 1, right. Now under this, what I'll do, I'll add the file. I'll upload it through my desktop. We have recent upload, my drive state, from anywhere we can upload. So I'll click on upload, browse, and browse a folder created for this, and then I'm adding the syllabus copy. Now this syllabus copy is for classwork. Then at the same time, I'll add one more file. Upload, browse, then for lab syllabus copy, right. Now here for same, third BTEC first sem students, all students, then under topic I'll add the topic as course information. Now this is what the importance of creating a topic in classroom. Then I'll click it as post. Right, now under course information, I have created course syllabus copy. Under course syllabus copy, I have both classroom syllabus as well as lab syllabus. This is how the topic button or the topic is used. Topic is used to create the topics under which we will be sharing some material. Right, in the same way, I create one more tab under material, or otherwise I'll create one more topic as topic. Under topic, now what I'll put, I'll put unit 1, right, and I'll add it. Right, now unit 1 will contains all the materials of unit 1. So to add the material, again I'll click on create, then material. Under material, I'll click as subtopic of unit 1. For example, if it is introduction to microprocessor, I'll write it as introduction to microprocessor and microprocessor and micro controllers, right. Under description, it is like a first topic of unit 1, right. Under this, I can add any file via YouTube link or file or anything whichever I want to add in the same way what we have done for topic type, right. Now here what I'll do, I'll put this under unit 1. So we have to select topic. At the right side we have to select topic. In topic, I'll select it as topic 1, then I'll post it. Then it will appear in topic 1. This is how we manage the classwork under classwork tab. In next video, I'll show you how to add students and Google Meet, which are very much required to begin a class at the starting of any academic year. Thank you.